Hello, Zedhead, and welcome back to Beacon. So, it looks like the mods is something you can do on the side. So, you can remove a mutation. So, basically, if I do that one. Oh, you place it on top of it. Because I want that to be young. That's 2 times 1 stats. So what happens if I do this? Add random stat, remove random stat. Plus 3 mutation life. Oh wait. Oh. Is that what the tool is? How long the mutation stays? Invert all stats. Is this something that is severely negative? Plus mutation life. Yeah, actually, remove that. Plus mutation life on this. Let's do add random stats to like jolted veins and see what this does with sequence. Yeah, so this is how you get item unlocks. So bone drains. So by using the DNA.
Sequencing genome.
Plus 3 mutation life, remove mutation, add a new DNA stat health. And then the other ones are locked. So that's different. But it looks like you can do a lot of crazy stuff with this, especially when you have a lot of DNA. Also, I do like the character changes. Oh wait, that's the one I tried to read last time and then it crashed. If I look, just bear with me here. Well, this is you writing this, or I guess a cloned version of you, the original you. Because he died when the ship crashed into the side of this planet. Look, this is messed up, okay? I've had a look around outside of the crash ship, and I think I've started to get a handle on the situation. That's why I'm writing this down. I'm hoping this will get you up to speed. The ship is completely totaled. As you can probably see, the clone bay is still working, obviously, but pretty much everything else either is or was on fire. The ship's distress beacon is gone too. It was gone by the time it came out, so I have no idea what happened to it. But listen, that thing is designed to survive crashes, so it's got to be still operational. As of right now, I'm still getting a signal for it on the locator, so I'm going to follow that. You'll see soon enough, but it's kind of a war zone out there. From where I'm standing, finding that beacon is literally the only hope to get out of here. I've seen enough dead versions of us to realize that I'm probably not going to be the one to make it. To be completely honest, you probably aren't either. But one of us will. You just have to keep going. Okay, keep trying. Alright, nice pep talk. Good luck. Oh, wait. I can just keep reading this. And it looks like I have a normal weapon. I should actually have a boundary on that. That's health. So open, and we get V16 SMG. The term submachine gun perhaps unfairly maligns the weapon we are presenting here today. After all, the Kaiser-Smith SMG is no way less capable than the full machine gun. Rather, We've simply taken the best aspects of the heavier weapon, its automatic firing mode, and high fire rates, and married them to a lighter, more user-friendly form factor. While this has resulted in a higher spread and smaller magazine size, the resulting weapon remains perfectly perfect for cramped indoor incursions. Where a full machine gun would be clumsy and cumbersome, one for the guerrilla on the go fires mini plasma rounds, high fire rate, and low ammo capacity. 24 bullets. Yeah, that's pretty low for a machine gun. So it looks like the DNA mutations have like a certain amount of time before they expire. And then you can apply new ones. Security drone. There's one still alive somewhere. Oh, is he behind this? Oh, that weapon though. Oh, that's how you switch. Oh yeah, this is not a bad weapon. At all. Pretty fast reloading. Let's see, health. Oh, that's the sacrifice one. Let's visit the sacrifice shrine. I was too high up to actually hit it. Minimize me. The game on me. No jump bar pad. Yeah, so they're actually enemies. Well, that one just jumped off the window. Out the window. Open these. So there's Wild Feast. And what's this one? Let's see. Oh, all stats except health. Are increased. Really? That's a passive. That's not, that's really neat. I don't need the full health thing. So these are always different then. I just made it. I'll say just, it takes a bit. I almost hit the jump pad. Need more damage. Yeah, that hurt. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that mining laser was way higher on damage. Also, that's a higher tier enemy. It doesn't look like it gives you anything. Killing higher tier enemies. Oh, that burning is from one of my abilities. Volatile DNA. next area. I'm gonna need a lot of passes. Oh, the burning effect is really useful. Let's see. What's this? Oh, the scavenger shop. There is a munition thing. I don't know what's down here. That's a large crate. There's a passage. Or it just throws me back. Also, I have no clue what this is. Some kind of updraft. Yeah, this is the so that's 900. But it's still way too expensive. 100 for oh, just look over these pipes it. Oh, I'm pretty sure that's DNA. Oh, it's a weapon! Let's actually switch this out with the other weapon. So, small handheld device comprised of hardened bone-like materials and subtle animal matter. Origin unclear, but appears to be operational in a manner similar to a conventional pistol. When squeezed, the yielding lower part of the sharp object will activate some kind of reaction, propelling a congealed ball of noxious mucus out of the barrel. Fires acidic pustules. Fire mega acidic pustule on crit. Quickly regenerates ammo. Low damage. So, recycle this one. And we get incendiary ammo. So that's neat, so you only get the lore once, and then you can probably look it up. Let's see what the impeder does. Yeah, that might not be that great of a weapon. What's this? Looks like it's taking damage. And there's another one. But a few other things. Oh yeah, the fire effect is really useful. DNA and HP. That thing is defensive. And now it's dead. But DNA mods. Uh, has a bunch of money. A holo projector. Health and money. Grenade and health. Also, what is this? Can I shoot this? Yep, I can. Void orb health pickup. There's a bunch of crates here. What's this? Oh, it's the wrist monitor. Did that pick everything up? Looks like it. That's just health. Oh, there's another one of these. About to trigger. Let's roll for it. We've been there. Now we need to go straight up. Don't drop that. Oh, I haven't been here. Oh. Bad enemy. That all went flying. Oh, I also can't get past this. Until the shield runs out. At least I can heal. Oh wait, there's something down here. And that one died before he could do anything. A wild in that form, you can really can't do that much damage to it. So that's the cache. Palia cap. The sun-drenched cap of the Palia fungus. Still soft and fragrant. Fragrant from recent harvest, acting as the plant's primary source of energy. Through the collection of sunlight, the cap contains highly allowable flesh that, when eaten, grants substantial benefits, unlike more robust sections of the plant. The cap is easily digestible, however, due to some unknown nature of the plant, the exact benefit bestowed are unpredictable. Plus 42 a random stat. So did that just give me... Does that random stat up? Oh, so what did he need to attack from behind? Oh, that's a higher tier version. That's why I'm having trouble. Well, there is another way of dealing with this. Get that at the form. More DNA mods. This is a pretty big area. getting a stupid amount of DNA mods. Well, not... Well, basically a stat cell. Now I need to find a way up there. Oh, I'd rather have all stats up. Get more health. Reload. I'm pretty sure I need to go in here. Or not, wait a minute. No, I'm an idiot. I think it's this one. More rot vines. Let's go straight up. Yep, dead vines. I'll say that hurts. I took a few points of damage. So not too horrible. I see, can't I just run past these? Yep. Storm is a pretty decent weapon. And we get explosive armor. LMG. Let's see. V60 light machine gun. Don't get us wrong, we love explosives. Really, we do. But when you're faced with overwhelming infantry numbers, we still believe that the Kaiserschmitt automatic light machine gun is the number one weapon for mass suppression. As you might expect, our LMG goes beyond just automatic. Keep the trigger pressed for a few seconds and it will warm to its task, increasing its fire rate and projectile speed until you've got bullets that simply don't stop after initial impact. Sure, the kickback will mean that you have less say over exactly where the those bullets will go, but you better believe that whatever it does hit will feel it, as will everything behind it for several dozen yards. Fire plasma rounds, large ammo capacity, continuous fire causes shots to penetrate. Oh! Oh, that's neat. Ricochet ammo, scrap that. And that's barrage. Oh, I'm running. And we're done with the level. Oh, it's the lock again. Yeah, so it looks like you can just read that every time you go through this. Wait a minute, it says new lock. I'm pretty sure I already read that now. This is dangerous. zipline. Oh yeah, I think I like this weapon. More health. Yeah, I feel like I do way more damage with this. Less accurate, but it's way more damage. Oh, get there in 10 minutes. I don't mean I just need to run past the first level. And not pick up anything. Won't actually be a strategy though. Just run as fast as you can. There was a bunch of small insects coming after me. Oh, I need to go up here. There's quite some kind of key card. Oh, there's a bunch of enemies on the ground. Oh, that's a key card. Oh, there's a bunch of spaces you can go. Pyro pistol. Tesla mod, grenade mod. So that's 300. Let's actually buy this. Then swap. Initially designed as a luxury gardening tool for the upper echelons, it was quickly discovered that while the pyro pistol was effective at burning away weeds, it also burned away all matter underneath and around the weeds for several feet. Nevertheless, we know a strong design when we see one, and why the pistol was sent through R&D once again for potential alternate uses. The result is now before you, a light portable weapon that lobs balls of fire at the target, splashing out in a pool of flames on impact, perfect for burning away biological obstructions of any variety. So, fire explosive fireball projectiles, least flame pool, no ammo capacity. But now I can do this, and we get a quill flippers. A somewhat ramshackle collection of quills, tightly packed together with vines, though rudimentary, this appears to provide fired shots with the potential to burst on impact, releasing the quills with substantial kinetic force and causing secondary harm to anything within the affected radius. Chance to release quills on it. Oh, that might be a bit better. It's a slow fighting weapon. Kind of the only issue. And also I'm on fire now. Fire does not want to be turned off. Let's go. Tesla grenade. Tesla mod, evoking the spirit of ingenuity of the renowned Earth inventor from whose company they take their name. Our Tesla grenades are designed to explode an impressive display of electric arcs, seeking out and rebounding twice of every target within the grenade's area of effect. That's not all, however. With the grenade's ability to detect and distinguish between targets within an area, an additional electrical arc is generated for each detected hostile, both compounding the damage on all targets and creating an effective crowd control device in tight spots. Tax explosion on contact. Spawns one arc per enemy in contact zone. That's a sonic revolver. Let's switch these out. Sound. Since the dawn of man, we've relied on our ears to learn more about our surroundings, to warn us of danger, to perceive beauty invisible to the eye. For thousands of years, we've listened, heard, observed, and learned. Isn't it about time we started making some noise? Prince's new Sonic S1 revolver utilizes super compressed sonic waves, transforming sound into lethal projectiles that penetrate on impact, able to decimate multiple targets and in turn offset a reduced firing rate when compared to more traditional firearms. So fires explosive sonic projectiles, high damage, self-damage warning. Oh. Oh, we got pyro ammo. So health. So that was just an ammo cache. That goes down. Unless there's something here. Yeah, battle. Damn it. Reload. That is a high defensive unit. Probably does do more damage. Oh. I really hate that they can just jump you off the cliff. Like a lot of the enemies are just programmed to drop you off the cliff instead of dealing direct damage. I was almost dead. And he died. and we get something new, Tesla Serum. In a continued initiative to display gratitude to our loyal workers at Prism and elsewhere, we have created a new Tesla Serum, removing the necessity of providing a balanced schedule to our workforce. This revolutionary injection allows the recipient to regenerate energy at a rapid pace and get back to work with boundless determination. The company gains more focused work hours, and the workforce no longer loses efficiency. A win-win situation. Stamina regeneration speed reduces melee and darts. Nope. Now we need to find a way to get all the way up. I'm pretty sure it's this. Nope. I need to go straight up. That doesn't seem like a guy. Oh, wait. Forgot about the secret. That's loud. So I'm pretty sure I need to go in here. Something I did not notice. Unless that's not... No, I've been here. That's not the way to go. Then it's this side? I'm pretty sure this drops you to the others. Oh wait, I see it. It's over there. Wait. It prevented me from jumping. So it's on this? On the other side. Wrong. Before more stuff respawns. So I never saw this? Well, I'm blind. No, I saw this. I've been here. Now where is the way to go up there? So that jumps me up here. Amidst a bunch of enemies. Last time it was on that thing. Or is that one here? Oh, it's the one on the back.
Storm cell incoming.
That looks dangerous. Am I supposed to be up here? Rotspore Heart. I like the spores that act as the Rotspore's defense mechanism. A Rotspore Heart consists of extremely nutritious flesh that benefits beyond any pound in terrestrial food. Upon consumption, the recipient will find themselves rejuvenated and revitalized beyond their normal limits. In beyond this, though, they find that these previous limits have been permanently increased. I'm pretty sure I was not supposed to be there yet. I could have just skipped that. Kind of secret broke it. There we go. I'm guessing once you get through all the lore, it's probably gonna get way faster going through the levels. What if the scent of secrets are discovered? So every level has a stupid amount of secrets. Oh, we're on these levels again. Sounds like something's dying. Transmit it destructible. No clue what that does. Destroy transmitters to unlock. Oh, wait. I need to destroy all the transmitters. That's like a puzzle element to this. How do I hit that? But I don't remember these enemies being here on this level. What ship weapon? What's that do? That's a bunch of enemies. Pure chaos. Oh, that thing's still alive. I did not realize how much health I had. But he just killed himself. Refill nades. Let's see. Boss located. Sorry I'm late writing back. Things are pretty busy here. Taking me a while to get used to the layout here. I swear some days I come in and the entire place looks completely different. Anyway, I'm working on finding a birthday present for Auntie T. But it looks like the one You said she wanted might be in pretty high demand. Are you sure that's the only one she'd like? It's just there's a lot of choice. And most of the others would have a lot easier to get my hands on. Anyways, let me know. Sure, I can find it if I need to. Bestie. So, apparently there's a boss here. There's also a massive army. I got a riot shotgun. The world today is a complicated place. Technology, for all its benefits, can be confusing and fatal hurdle in the heat of battle. For those who are looking for something with a little more simplicity, he presents the Kaiserschmitt K4 riot shotgun. Taking our cues from the simpler times, the K4 is designed to solve your disputes up close and personal, with as much force behind each shot as possible. Was there a face in front of you when you pulled the trigger? Not anymore, there isn't. Isn't it? With the K4 penetrant plasma spread, you'll be picking bits of teeth out of your hair for weeks. By a spread of impact plasma rounds. Oh, that's loud. I do not like that just because of the massive sound. What the hell? Fell out of the wheel. Well, wait, where's my other weapon? Also, apparently I can't fire anymore. My reticle is not moving anymore? And dodge? Something happened when I picked that up. Even my controls are not functioning. Am I supposed to fight anything? Yeah, I can't fire anymore. Can't cycle weapons.
Surface level elevator access offline. Insufficient power.
Yeah, there's no way of finishing this now. None of my buttons going up. Well, time to die. Yeah, there's no way. Oh, accept fate. Am I immune? So I'm pretty sure I can't die as well. So the game worked out completely. Like, basically my character is dead. I've still the same health. Can't move. Return to menu. And if I continue, I get set back to the start of the level, I'm guessing. Yep. That's shitty. I keep getting issues with this game. Well, time to run straight to the end. Because I'm not going through all of this shit. Just open lock. I see. It looks like it rerolled the... Yeah, I need to go there. Yeah, this entire area is dark, completely dark now. what's that? Remote hack. I don't care. Do I need to go? So, do I need to go in? Oh, that's the alternative weapon. Take your booster. I think I fell out of the world. Yeah, no clue. I don't get the idea that I need to do something with the radio booster. It feels like there should be a jump pad here. Unless I now completely bugged out the game. Even further. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's bugged out. Oh, it's directional. Now I get it. What the hell? Volatile DNA. That's a new one. So I'm guessing this works the same way. Yep. Got experience. What experience do you make? And get kicked off immediately by a grenade. I'm just gonna run through this. Did he just run through that platform? Yeah, boss located. Give me the boss. He just stomped me. Take that. Oh, you can actually break those. This is just such a dark level compared to what was before that bugged me out. Really? Can you not? Looks like it's a range thing.
Surface level elevator access offline. Insufficient power.
Equipment. So the reactor is down there, and apparently there's something here. Oh, it's the it's that shop. What's that mini launcher? Regenerative shield passive. EM flare. mini launcher. Let's do this. After introducing our popular R9 rapid rocket launcher model, we received a great deal of feedback. Long story short, people loved it. They raved about the ability to control the number of rockets fired with each barrage. It was the first truly democratic multiple round rocket launcher on the market. There was just one criticism. It was too big, too powerful. It was difficult to fit into the busy transitory life. Introducing then a lightweight alternative, the R3 rapid rocket launcher from Kaiser Smith. Using a new spooling mechanism to allow users to change their output on the fly. Users can change their weapon to unleash between one or three mini rockets, depending on what the situation demands. The Kaiser Smith Rapid Rocket Mini Launcher, a travel size rocket launcher for a merc on the go. So, homing mini missile shards to increase missiles fire, low ammo capacity, self damage warning. This one, and we get pyro ammo. Yeah, let's try the mini rocket launcher, because these should be homing. That's destructive. It's probably great at fighting bosses. Let's switch. For some reason, they're completely useless against these guys. Tesla droid. Flux node. What the fight DNA? Oh, the fighting against each other. Base DNA. Oh, that's a level 2. Also, that thing seems to be homing it like crazy. What's that in the middle? Apparently, I have acid slime on me. Oh, so it's fine. That's a transmitter. I need to go there. So it looks like. That's poisonous. What the hell? Oh, those are codex entries.
Power restored. 2. Surface elevator access.
That's a problem. That's a problem.
Storm cell incoming.
Pretty sure I need to go up here. That's a lot. That's a lot.
Storm
kind of hard to deal with. I'm pretty sure he does not like that. The fire upon him that it's trying to charge. Oh yeah, that was stupid damage. I'm stunned. There's a constant onslaught of drones. Or droids, I should say. And that's it. Was this open? Paramount DNA. Oh, that is way different. Tesla strike. That's not the same type of build. Deploy Tesla strikes at cursor. Tiny remote that fits in the palm of your hand. Packed full of our most advanced technology ever. And with a single press, you can call down the power of the gods. This changes everything. Coupled with singularly accurate planetary positioning system, the Prism Tesla Strike is accurate to within a couple of feet, allowing a deadly spear of electricity to be summoned as fast as, well, as fast as a lightning strike. Yeah, I'd rather have that one. So there was something on this. Oh, reach within 15 minutes to get at that.
Now descending to surface level waste processing facilities.
So I'm guessing there's two bosses then.
Please ensure proper hazard wear. Arrive at waste processing facility 06.
So that's this level. Well, that's halfway through, and that took me like an hour. Let's continue. Hopefully not get a bug anymore. They seriously do fix a few of the bugs. Hey, so it's pretty obvious now that I've got to head inside. Whatever it is this corp was building here, that's the way my locator is pointing, so that's the way I go. Our beacon ended up there is beyond me, but I've come too far to turn back now. As expected, security is getting tighter and tighter. Well, to be honest, I'm more concerned about those containers littering the place. Or cells will probably be a better word over them. A lot of them are empty, but others, they seem to be imprisoning aliens here. There's no way all these guys are indigenous to this planet. So they're being shipped here from all over the place. Because why? Did they manage to crash into an undeclared prison colony? With a side venture in mining? Anyway, good news is the ex-prisoners don't seem to be any more fond of their ex-guards than I am. If I can maintain a low profile, I might even be able to slip past some of the fighting and head inside. So we need to go up. On looted surface. At least my damage is pretty high. So what's that? Lumos Island? Locked gate? Crate? I really can't see. Like, this is completely screwed. Inspect. Subject, don't. Do not go to anyone about this. I don't know what you think you saw, but I do know that policy with this kind of stuff. You've worked here long enough to know it too. Don't be stupid, just keep your head down for a bit. You still haven't taken me to these viewpoints, remember? One of my teammates owes me a favor, so I can definitely sneak off for a couple of hours of quality gazing. So let's just do that. Let's see. I kind of want to see what that one is. It is an excavator headquarters. They being able to just stop me is mortifying. DNA. It's down there. What's this? A flux node. What's this? Fortress passageway. Where is that thing I'm trying to find? Oh, it's further down, maybe?
Storm south incoming.
Maybe not. That's a different enemy. That one was way bigger than the others. Oh, there's a bunch of hell. So yeah, I need to kill the transmitters. I can just shoot these. Don't need the tornadoes. I probably shouldn't walk through that. Sonic grenades. Nope. So it looks like explosive can negate that protective field. Quite easily. Okay, it does stop spawning. What's this? Well, that's kind of like force field. Oh, that's a lot of enemies. Game's like, you're not supposed to be here yet. You're supposed to die. Completely sealing me up. Wait, is there a way down it? Yep. Energy blasted. Well, let's just sacrifice that. Oh. So I can actually still get that stuff without the transmitter. That thing's a pain in the ass. It does drop health. Let's just do this. And that's all. They kind of don't stand a chance against this weapon. Do I really care? Probably not. The only thing that I find useful is finding weapons, sacrificing them for the weapon mods. So like you're better off getting a lot of the passives and a good weapon. And at that point it doesn't really matter.
Elevator access offline. Insufficient power.
Now I'm burning and have acid. I'll level 2 enemy. Activate that thing. Loads. Kill that guy. Stay away from the droid. Great for healing. It's horrible to fight. Fourth port of fight HP. That's able to just drop you through the platform. So I don't need to go there. It's really trying to kill you with numbers. Oh, there's someone there as well. That is way too many enemies. And I'm off the platforms. No, I'm not off the platforms yet. I did drop some health. Oh wait, where do I need to go? At least not this way. Billy? Well, I killed a bunch. I have a bunch of abilities. Oh well. So let's see. Yeah, so two of them. One of them completely disappeared. And I can actually remove that one. But now we got a bunch, like Paramount DNA. Minus 3 auxiliary cooldown. Plus 23 speed. Plus 8% resistance. Minus 46 health, which is insanely dangerous. Well, I'm guessing this is because I killed a boss. I kind of like the system. And then all the random mutations. So yeah, up to the time that this runs, so if you have a good mutation that you want to keep, you can always just use the mods. Which you also find in the levels, so... 3 times 1 stat, remove mutation. Do all stats up. Invert stat, invert random stat. But yeah, that's it for this episode. So thank you for watching and hope to see you in the next one.